Hello, beautiful and handsome boys and girls. You're welcome to our online lessons. I am Mwanda Hamid. I'm going to take you through mathematics. The 22nd lesson. This is the 22nd lesson. We have gone far. We have really learned. So we have discussed so many things so far. And we are just going ahead. We shall not take much time to go back. So what you do when we give you an activity, make sure you do it well, and we shall come. We shall call for those books to check them. I always tell you that. We shall call to check, and when we find any problem, we shall call you to do or to repeat the whole work. So make sure when you are doing the work, settle and do it very, very well. So, we are moving on today, and we are going to look at something new, addition of numbers using a number line. What I know in P1 and P2, we have ever learned about this, the using of a number line. So we are just going to add on what we covered in P1 and P2. So that means this is going just to be a walkover. So before I give a brief background about a number line, just very briefly, and what I know, much of the work, much of the background, you learn it when you go to P4 and P5. Now, a number line has represent integers. We write there integers, and integers are numbers. Now, when you go to P5, they will tell you integers are in three. We have three integers. One, we have negative integers, we have zero integer, then we have positive integers. Now for us in P3, we only handle two. We handle zero integer, then positive integers. So when you go to upper classes, that's when they introduce negative integers when you are big. So when we are adding numbers, we are only going to add positive numbers, and we shall be running on one side of the number line. When we are representing a number, it has two sides divided by zero. We have negative side, positive side, then zero in the middle. But for us in P3, we shall begin from zero and deal with one side of positive briefly. So what do we do when we are dealing with a number line? We are going to add three plus 2. We are going to add 3 plus 2. So how do we add 3 to 2 using a number line? First of all, the number line is not there, so you are required to draw it. So get a ruler and draw a straight line. Now on your straight line, you are going to put arrows. I put that arrow. What does it represent? This arrow represents that the number line is still continuing that side. It does not stop there. That's why I show using this arrow. Then even this way also, as I told you, it has two sides, negative and positive, then zero in the middle. So it increases the positive side, then also increases the negative side. It doesn't end. It goes up to infinity. It doesn't stop. So I indicate that using arrows. Okay? Now, I said we are only dealing with positives. So after doing that, after drawing that, you will still get your ruler and put these lines. These are lines that are going to hold now the integers. I'm going to write here numbers. So when you are drawing them, make sure you draw them in equal distance. They are represented in what we call equidistant. And what equidistant means? Equal distance. Now from one integer to another, or from one number to another. I don't expect any where someone draws this line and this one is too close, then the other one is too far. That is wrong. They are represented in equal distances, equidistant. So we are going to indicate them in equal distance. You don't measure, but you have to estimate just like that. So what do I do after that? I will now put there my numbers. I said we are dealing with two, zero and a positive part. So I'm going to put 0 here, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So after that, what do we do? After drawing our number line, we are now going to add 3 plus 2. And on a number line, what we do when we are dealing with a number line, we count steps. If we are saying 3, meaning we are going to count 3 steps on a number line. Just like you walk. I walk a step. If I'm standing here and I start walking, I will make 1 step, 2 steps, 3 steps, and I keep making. So that's what we also do on a number line. We count the steps. From 0, you now count. When you make a jump or a step, that's when you say 1. But if I'm beginning from here, I can't say 1. This is already 0. So when I go to another step, that's when I will say 1. When I continue, I will say 2. When I continue, 3. So I keep counting steps, and the steps are on these integers. From one integer to another, that is a step. Or from one number to another, that is a step. So we are going to count. I'm going to count. Count with me. The first one is saying 3. So I'm going to count how many steps? 3 steps. Now can we count together? We are beginning from here. First indicate the line. I'm going to begin from 0. Then I count how many steps? 3 steps. Can we count together? When I come here, that's 1, 2, 3. Meaning I'm going to stop there. So I have to indicate that this is a stopping line now. Then after that, I will join from where I began up to where I stopped. Now, these are movements. If I'm moving, I have to take a certain direction. So I usually face, if I face this way, I'm taking a certain direction. So how do you know that I have moved steps on this numbering? You have to show this as an arrow. So you have to indicate the direction you have been moving. So since I began from 0 going to this side, I will show that I was taking that direction. So my arrow will be in front, not where you began from. I began from here going the other side. So my arrow will be in front. And this is, I have moved 3 steps there. So you have to indicate the arrow, then you also indicate the steps you have moved. Now we are going to add. When we are adding on a numbering, this is very simple. If I move 3, 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to add, I don't go back. I will begin from where I have stopped. So I'm going to begin again here and add 1, 2. So when we come back to our numbering here, if I have stopped here for 3, then my 2 will still begin from where 3 has stopped. So you raise it, you draw another starting line slightly above where the first one has stopped. Slightly above, you draw another line. Then I count how many steps? 2 steps. So I'll come and count 1, 2. Meaning I'm going to stop here. I've counted 2 steps, so I'm going to stop there. Then I will come and join. Remember, I'm beginning from where the first one has stopped. So this is my 0. Then I join here. So if I join, it means I was taking that direction. Began from here, stopped here. So my arrow will be where I have stopped. And then you indicate how many steps are there. So I said 3, and this will be plus 2. So that is 3 plus 2 steps. And where do you get the answer? Where the second movement has stopped. So your answer will be down here. And on a number line, my dear children, we also have to indicate the answer arrow. And how do we indicate the answer arrow? Where you began from, the first movement began from 0 up to where the second one stopped. I had the first one 0 up to 3, and the second one moved from 3 2 steps up to here. So we'll have to go up to where the second one has stopped and then join. Still, this one will also be an answer arrow. So it is beginning from 0 up to 5. Then I'll indicate my arrow where it has stopped, and then also put the 5. Meaning, this means 3 plus 2 equals to 5. So indicate your answer on that down arrow. After this, this is a method of adding using a numbering. So you come down and say 3 plus 2 equals to 5. This is now your conclusion. So after making your conclusion, my good children, you know what to do. Come and underline smartly like that. I hope you have enjoyed it. Very simple. Very simple work. So I'm going to go through another number and we'll see how to catch up. Number two, I have 5 plus 4. What is 5 plus 4? So what is our first step? We are going to draw a number line. Smartly draw a number line. So what shouldn't miss on a number line? I have the arrow that shows that the number line is still continuing. Then I have another arrow here also shows that the number line is continuing the other side. So what are we going to do there? Put the integers, put the numbers. But you make sure that these numbers are in equal distance without measuring but just estimating. You will know that this is the distance that I want throughout like that. So after that, I'll now indicate my numbers. The first one is 0. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It is continuing. So you can go up to 12, 15, and so many others. It is endless. So from there, what are we going to do now? The first person is going to move how many steps? 5 steps. So I'm going to begin from 0. Put where the beginning point, you first mark here. Then after marking, you know this is your 0, so you are counting steps. Can we count together? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to stop here. So I put there the line where I'm going to stop. Then after that, I will join now. Draw this arrow like that. And where are we going to put our arrow? Where we stopped. We're moving from this way, going to the other direction. So the arrow will point in the direction you have been moving to. So after that, what else do we indicate on that arrow? We shall indicate the 5 steps. The steps that we have counted. Then after that, we have finished 5, so we are going to 4. Now the next person is going to move how many steps? 4 steps. Does it come back on 0? No. Where the first one has stopped is where you begin from. So I'm going to begin from here, slightly above, draw the beginning point slightly above the first person, the first runner. I can call this one the first runner. The first runner moved how many steps? 5 steps. Now draw slightly above. So how many steps will the second runner move? The second runner will move 1. How many steps? 4 steps. So this is my 0. And I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. So my second runner will stop there. Then I join. My second runner will move up to there. So I was moving from 0 here to the other direction. So my arrow will be where I stop. Where that runner has stopped. And what do we indicate above? This is plus 4. So we moved 5 steps and we added 4. Steps, and where will our answer be? Down, where the second runner has stopped. So when we come for the answer, begin from 0, where you began from, where the first runner began from, to meet the second runner. So the second runner stopped here and is here waiting for the for that last one. So the last runner will run to meet the second runner. So this one will combine the two, the first one and the second one. So put the arrow at the stopping point, and the answer is at the stopping point. So this is 9. So you come and make your conclusion. You say 5 + 4 = 9. Then after that, what shall we do? We shall come and smartly underline. Smartly underline, and then that is okay. That is that. I hope you have learned something. I hope you have understood. And my good children, I request to stop there. Make sure you go through these lessons. If you think there is a problem, you can go back and replay and watch smartly and do the given work very well. So I'm going to give you some few numbers, then I will come and we'll begin from there. Thank you for learning. Bye-bye.